Now, your Super Doppler 10 forecast with meteorologist Jeremy Wheeler.
All right, this is Matthew on satellite. It has regained the eye. For a while this morning, there was no eye. It had filled in, it weakened a little bit. Now the eye is back clearly. And this appears to be moving off to the northwest. We'll see what the latest official is. The latest official has it moving northward at 8. I wonder if the next update around 2 p.m. will adjust that. Winds of 130 miles an hour sustained, 950 millibars. So that has come down a little bit since this morning. Still a Category 3 hurricane. Still expected to be a hurricane, a Category 3, as it moves across the Bahamas. And this is headed for Nassau. This is headed for the Big Island. And it's really going to shake things up there with some high winds, possibly destructive winds, high storm surge, and heavy rain. After that point, it will move off towards Florida. This is into Thursday now. This is 8 p.m., 130 mile an hour winds. Now, it might move inland. Some of the models have it moving inland. The official forecast has it skirting the coast there. But I think based off the latest models I'm looking at, I think it's easily possible for it to move inland into Florida. And then either way, it'll try and move offshore again or to the northeast. And then it will move northeast for just a brief period this time. Now it looks like it's going to turn more easterly going into Sunday. So this is Sunday morning, 8 a.m. Looks like it's going to be pretty far from our region. And matter of fact, this is the possible path. Southern end of the Outer Banks is barely in the possible path at that point. The most likely path takes it over 100 miles to our south. And then it looks like it's even almost 200 miles to our southeast by Monday morning. And we would have pretty low impacts here in Hampton Roads if it follows this track. Just remember, though, there's still some uncertainty in here. It still could come back to the north in the forecast. It had such a wild swing in the last 24 hours. I wouldn't be surprised if in the next 24 we see at least a change in the path. So here's the latest computer models. You know, they all started to agree last night that this would take more of an easterly turn, and even some of them still calling for a southerly turn and going back towards Florida. Could it come back this way after that point? Yeah, but let's focus on the short term. There's been so many wild swings in this. I want to say even just up to this point is going to be a challenge to get the forecast exactly right for the models and for everybody. So here's two more models. This is the GFS and the European, and we've been following this ever since Monday. So it still has some continuity here. There's agreement all the way up through Saturday evening at 9:30 that it's going to be south of South Carolina, and then they take it east and south, just like some of those other models. Even if that happens, there's going to be an area of high pressure to the north. There'll be some pretty strong winds coming in out of the east and northeast at that point. But of course, the strongest and more destructive winds will be closer to that center, far from us, far to the south. So we still could see some breeziness around here, especially over the southern Outer Banks. That's where we could still see some significant impacts. So because of that, and because that water travels, we could see some moderate tidal flooding across the Outer Banks. That's what this is for. Possibly major south. Depends on that track. If it gets a little more northward especially, then yeah, we could be dealing with some major tidal flooding down towards the Hatteras area. Strong winds Saturday and Sunday. They will pick up, even though the storm will be to our south most likely. But again, stay tuned for changes. Beach erosion is a given. We're going to see some of that, and also some high waves and overwash. Now for Hampton Roads, I mean, we'll see some breezy conditions between now and the weekend. Might pick up a little bit over the weekend, but we're not expecting destructive winds at this time. Less rain is forecast with the current track, 1 to 2 inches down towards northeast North Carolina, maybe 2 or 3 inches of rain. Minor tidal flooding is possible. Maybe some moderate, depends on the winds if they pick up. Now here's Tropical Storm Nicole. That was Matthew. Nicole, I'm just going to show it real quick. This one is going to stay out to sea in south of Bermuda, so that is not going to impact our forecast. We have an area of high pressure around here. We have northeasterly winds, but still we're getting this moisture coming in off the ocean, so we have quite a bit of clouds out there. And so today we are mostly cloudy, and we could see a couple of sprinkles, but that's about it. Our high temperatures are going to be in the 70s today. And we'll see low 70s with those breezy conditions. Going to stay cool for the next couple of days. And then getting into the weekend, the wind might pick up a little bit. Again, it depends on the track. But right now, Hampton Roads, we're looking okay, but we're not out of the woods. You need to still pay attention to the forecast.